been a long time. Been a long time coming. It's life or death for me, man. But you know, there's no turning back now. This is what makes me. This is what I am.
Feel me?
Let's go. You can hate me now,
QB,
but I won't stop now.
Real niggas,
cause I can't stop now.
Bravehearts,
you can hate me now.
Come on.
But I won't stop now.
Hate you too.
Cause I can't stop now. You can hate me now.
You don't give a fuck.
You can hate me now.
You ain't ready to do now.
Do it now.
I'd be Phoenix here, and today I'm gonna show you how to do your chest and tries. This is a beginner workout, so today we're gonna start out with the most common workout everybody knows about, the barbell chest press. We're gonna come over here. Alright, the chest press is a compound movement that uses your chest and your triceps. It's very important that you position your arms where they're supposed to go so you don't snap some shit. So your bar path, when you lift off, you want your arms to go straight down and straight up. Nothing like this, or too close either, or like that. You want to be straight up and straight down. Also, you don't want to flare out your shoulders over here or too close. You want to be in the middle so you don't have that much tension on your shoulders, because that's what tends to get hurt when people are performing chest press, the shoulders. So another thing you can do to improve your lift if you're doing heavier weight is contract your shoulders and then go back. That's gonna add power. Also, you can add curvature to your spine like that, but the natural curvature. You lift and keep everything tight. Also, when you lock out, you don't wanna lock out like that. You wanna lock out smooth. Remember, your breath, your bar path should be straight the whole time. Alright guys, that's the chest press. Grip. Barbell press is the same thing as bench presses, because you're gonna have a closer grip that's gonna focus it more on your triceps. Still on your pecs, but mostly on your triceps. So position yourself. Also, one thing you can do for either way you bench is retract your shoulders like that and then go back. It's gonna give you more stability on your lift. And you wanna have a closer grip. You don't wanna be right here. You don't wanna be over here. You wanna be like sort of right in the middle. You'll find your sweet spot, but it's the same concept. You keep your shoulders tight. Straight up. Straight up. Straight up. And you wanna keep the movement flowing. You don't wanna bang out too hard. You wanna keep it smooth. One last thing with either of those movements. I wasn't doing it right, but your breathing is really important. So you wanna have a rhythm with your breathing. So watch. You wanna. Have a rhythm when you breathe in and out as you're performing the movement. All right guys, that's the close grip chest press. Incline barbell press. This is a little bit more complex movement, still a compound movement. And you, with this one, you wanna be careful because at the beginning, it's gonna be harder than the chest press because you gotta use more stabilization. It's a little bit harder. So let's move over here. You wanna start with maybe 10, so just the bar, depending on how strong you are and how comfortable you are, but always start with the bar, just so you know how much weight you could handle. Alright, so the same concept, find your sweet spot, keep your shoulders straight out when you go up and down. I mean your arms in a straight path. The bar is going in a straight path. And your shoulders, you don't want them out here, that, you want them in here. Remember what I told you about the breathing, about the movements that I show you. That's it. The dumbbell flies. This is gonna pump out the middle of your chest.
and it's a little bit better if you do it with cables. If you have cables, I recommend using those, but in my home gym, I only got dumbbells.
So this movement, you want to be at a bench and be at an angle, or you could do it straight with a straight bench too.
But like this, I prefer it. Go straight up. Keep your arms not bent like this, not bent like this, but a little bit angled. So you're gonna feel it in your chest and contract your chest, not your arms. You want to move your chest. I don't know how to explain it, but you'll feel it. You gotta use your chest. And then the same concept with the breathing. And obviously this is really lightweight, but as you progress, you're gonna use the weight that's appropriate for your strength and skill. All right, guys.
That's dumbbell fly.
So with the closed grip chest press, that's gonna get your triceps a little bit warmed up so you can move on to a little bit more complex movement for your triceps. That's gonna isolate your triceps. So what you wanna do is grab a dumbbell, whatever weight you can manage and feel comfortable at. Position yourself at a stable base and go straight back. Let me show you from this angle. And you wanna keep your wrist straight the whole time so you don't fuck anything up. Try to keep your arms straight up as possible. And a variation you can do for that is if you do your 10 reps and this is your last set of your workout, you can just lower the weight by 5 pounds and bang out maybe your last 5. Or how many you could do just to completely burn out the muscle. And you could do that, the drop set, for every workout that I've shown you. You just do your set, your last set of that workout, and you decrease the weight by however much amount that you can handle for a couple more reps. And you bang out those reps right after your set of your last set. Yeah, this is a little bit more complex too. So you want to be careful with this movement. They're called skull crushers, because they can crush your skull. So what you need is an easy crumb bar. You use whatever weight is appropriate for you. You slide into it. Wow. That did not kick this move. Wow. Have your arms straight out and keep them straight up the whole movement. Keep everything tight. And then go straight up. Straight up. Straight up. It's very important that you touch your head, or at least go past your head, just so you can get the full range of motion. Don't go like right there, or right there. You wanna go all the way back to get the full range of motion of this workout. That's it. It's gonna be dips. This is gonna target your triceps and your chest. So it's gonna be, I'm gonna kill both of them at the same time. If you wanna hit your chest more, you gotta go a little bit wider. You wanna hit your triceps more, go closer. So this is basically the movement. Come over here to the side. So you wanna make sure you could just hold yourself up straight up. So the first step is go down slowly into a negative and explode up. Go down slowly into a negative, explode up. Go down, up, down, up, down, up. And depending on what your strength is, you're gonna do your sets according to how many reps you can do in a set. So if you can do 20 reps in a set, then do 3 sets of 20, or 20, 15, 10. However many you could do, that's just gonna kill out your shoulders and your chest, I mean your triceps and your chest completely.